In this video, we're going to learn how to use right triangles to answer some questions involving trig functions. So relationships between the trig functions and the inverse trig functions can often be simplified using the sketch of a right triangle. So let's start with part A. Here we're told to suppose that theta equals the inverse cosine of 3/5 and then define sine theta and tangent theta. So I've already said that I'm going to use a right triangle to help me answer this question. So let's go ahead and draw that triangle. So right triangle, and I've included an angle theta here. Now I'm told to suppose that theta equals the inverse cosine of 3/5. So how can I interpret that information? Well, another way I could say this is that theta is an angle that has a cosine of 3/5. I could also write this as cosine of theta equals 3/5. So what I want to do is just set up my triangle according to that fact. I want to make theta have a cosine of 3/5. Now remember that cosine is the adjacent over the hypotenuse. Okay, so then I want this side to be 3 and this side to be 5, right? 3 here is my adjacent side and 5 is my hypotenuse. Now my ultimate goal is to find sine of theta and tangent of theta, and I'm going to be able to do that based on this triangle that I've set up. But before I can actually find those values, I need to find the other leg of my triangle here, the opposite side. And now we can find that side using Pythagorean Theorem, right? I should have 3 squared plus b squared, where b is this side here, equals 5 squared. So if I work that all out, I'm going to get that b equals 4, which if you're familiar with 3, 4, 5 right triangles, you might have already guessed that. Okay, so now that I have all the sides of my triangle filled in, I can go ahead and answer these questions. I can just read off what sine of theta is right from my triangle. So sine of theta should be the opposite over the hypotenuse, so 4/5. And then tangent of theta is the opposite over the adjacent side. So here that should be 4/3. All right, so just setting up this triangle based on this theta equals inverse cosine of 3/5 allowed us to easily find sine of theta and tangent of theta. So let's go ahead and move on to part B. In part B, we're told to simplify the sine of the inverse cosine of x over 3. And we're going to assume x is greater than 0 here. So this looks kind of complicated. I wouldn't know really how to simplify this just based off the algebraic expression here. But we can actually use a right triangle, very similar to the way we did in part A, to rewrite this expression. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the inside, with this inverse cosine of x over 3. And what I want to do is I want to draw a right triangle that has an angle, theta, that equals the inverse cosine of x over 3. Or in other words, I want to draw an angle theta such that the cosine is x over 3. So we just did something like this, right? Cosine is the adjacent over the hypotenuse. So then I can call my adjacent side x in my hypotenuse 3. And then what I'm ultimately looking for then is if I've called theta this inner part, inverse cosine of x over 3, my final step here is to figure out then what sine of theta is. But of course, to figure out sine theta, I need to fill in my opposite side here. So once again, we're just going to use Pythagorean Theorem to figure that out. So I have x squared plus b squared equals 3 squared. And I'm going to solve this for b. So I get b squared equals 9 minus x squared, and then I take the square root to get b equals the square root of 9 minus x squared. And notice I'm taking the positive root here. I don't want a negative side on my triangle. So then we have that this opposite side is the square root of 9 minus x squared. And now I can go ahead and read off from my triangle here what sine of theta is. Okay, and that should be the opposite over the hypotenuse. So square root of 9 minus x squared over 3.